Hello everyone, welcome to Trendy Education, and in this video I'm going to explain you what is data mining. And before that, I would like you to explain what is data and what is mining. So what is data? In a sense, a data is nothing but the information, so which is either your information, that is my own information, or others information. So what is my own information? In the sense, my audio, my video, my images, my WhatsApp chats and everything. So this is my own data. But what is others' data? In the sense, for example, take running a website or app, I may get the details of others. So this is the other data. So this is what data. So what is mining in the sense? So in general, what is mining? Extracting or searching something. So coal mining in the sense, searching for coal. That is what we are going to do here. So mining in the sense, extracting something. So we are going to extract the data. Extract the data and filter them to get a useful pattern. So this is what data and this is what mining. So combining these two, we get the definition of the data mining. So in this data mining, we are using the raw data. So we are having only the raw data. Using this raw data, we are going to convert it into a useful information. So first one is extracting. So we are going to extract the usable data from those all data. Not every data we are going to use. Some particular data we are going to extract. And the next thing is, it is the process of, we are having raw data and we are just going to convert this raw data into a useful format. So why we are converting this raw data into a useful format? For analytics, for some purpose. For example, by using all data, we may not get something easily. So to get what the data is actually, we are using this data mining. Next thing is, we can find a useful pattern. So how we find an useful pattern? Let me tell you an example. For example, I'm going to a shopping, okay. If I buy diaper, so diaper means, it means that I'm having a baby, or one of my family members is having baby. So that's why I buy diaper. So if I buy diaper, there may be chances for me to buy milk. So we can easily find some pattern. So using data mining, we can find the pattern very, very easily using all the data. So coming to the next part, the next thing is, data mining is used to develop effective marketing strategies. So how? First I'll write and I'll explain how. So, data mining will help you to develop an effective marketing strategy. That is, a strategy in the sense, plan. So, it will give you every data in a single plane. So, single sheet or single something. So, using this single, we can easily identify this week sales and last week sales. So, using this, we can also predict the future sales. So increase in sales, decrease in sales can be easily predictable using the data mining. So here the data mining is used to develop an effective marketing strategies. And it is also used to build models. Models for applications. For some applications, we can use some models. That is, to build those models, we need data mining here. The definition for data mining I'm going to write now. It is nothing but the process of finding, I'll write, first, it is the process of extracting. So this mining words includes extracting, which means analyzing, extracting the data from a large data repository. So what is large data repository? It is not simply about your data, that is only my data. It includes million people's data. So it is not only a single database, it includes many. It's a very large database, so that's why we call it as large data repository. So the next thing I'm going to explain is where it is commonly used. So data mining is commonly used in real time. So I'll give you some examples and also the explanation for those. The first thing I already told you in marketing strategies and spam messages and mails, spam emails. So in your Gmail, you can see a folder called spam. So what is spam in the sense? It is not sent by you or some fake. So this is some simply called as spam. So how it consider it's a spam mail in the sense? Using the header and the content of the mail email, we can see the data mining techniques are used and applied to this email, and it will classify it as it is a spam mail and it is a normal mail. So this is how a spam mail will work using the header and the content of the mail. For example, in the header section, some words like free. So these words are when used, we can, that is the data mining model will automatically classify it as spam mail. And the second thing is fraud detection. Fraud detection in the sense, it will easily find the outliers, that is the noise which is different, the characteristics which is different from rest of the characteristics, which is classified as the fraud detection. For example, in your credit card, let's assume that you have not done any transaction till now, but today you are going to transact some amount. So I'm going to transfer about 10,000 today. So when I transfer, it will give me a message. That is the data mining technique model will give me a message like 10,000 was transferred from your account. Please confirm it is you or not. So this is nothing but a fraud detection, because this characteristics is totally different from my previous characteristics. So this is why fraud detection is used. And database marketing. So I already told you what is database marketing, how it is used in the things. One is decrease and the increase of the sales. And the second thing is using if you are running a website or application, we may collect the details of about their gender and age. So using this, we can easily predict. For example, I'm running a cooking website. Probably there are 75% of females can check out my website, because most of the females are cooking. So this is how it works. That is using female and male part and using my age. So this between 15 to 25 age members are using my website regularly. So this type of data can be easily driven from this data type, that is data mining model. So this is how it is used in database marketing. Hope you understand. And if you like my video, then give me a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel and share it to your friends. And yeah, thank you. Bye.